Hello friends, my name is Ksenia and we are learning Russian. Today I want to touch a subject that I used to avoid for a long time because I think it's very complicated. Cases of nouns. Those students who used to receive my lessons by WhatsApp, they know about cases of nouns because we learned them for about a couple of months. Cases of nouns is a complicated subject because we have six cases, and then feminine, masculine, neuter, gender, plural, singular, they also have different endings in different cases, and then still we have exceptions, but still don't be scared of these different endings. Today I will give you six cases and explain what they mean, and then you will remember all these endings, not immediately, by listening a lot of examples. Where to take these examples? In my lessons, in any other lessons on the YouTube, or in movies, in reading books, talking to Russian people, maybe colleague, maybe friends, I don't know. So you can't learn these endings immediately, but you can learn them during some period of time. And also don't be scared, don't be afraid to make a mistake. For example, a book, книга, I see a book, я вижу книгу, ending U. But if you forget it and say, я вижу книга, книга, я вижу книга, Russian people will still understand you, will still understand you, because it's easy to understand what you mean. Nobody will laugh at you that you mix up an ending. So just speak, just listen, just speak. Talk, and you will remember all endings. If you will not, it's okay. Let's start. Cases of nouns. First, nominative case. This case answers questions who and what. It's an initial form of a noun, and it's usually a subject in a sentence. For example, dom, house, book, книга, a man walks along the street, человек идет по улице. So, nominative case, initial form. Then, genitive case. Genitive case shows that something belongs or refers to something. And we usually translate it into English with the preposition of. For example, bank of a river. So bank belongs to a river. So river, река. Берег, реки. So when we use река in genitive case, we say реки, ending E. Река, берег, реки. And it's only for река. For some other nouns, there will be different endings. Река, берег, реки. So genitive case, something belongs or refers to something of something. Then dative case shows that something is given or addressed to something. For example, I go to a doctor, so I address to a doctor, my direction is addressed to a doctor. Doctor in Russian also doktor or vrach, two words for doctor. Doktor, vrach, I go to the doctor, я иду к доктору, dative case. Доктору, доктор, nominative case, я иду к доктору, addressed to, я иду к доктору, доктор, я иду к доктору. Next case is accusative case. It shows that the noun is an object of an action. I read a book. A book is an object. We read it. Book. Книга. Я читаю книгу. Я читаю книгу. Книга. Я читаю книгу. Instrumental case shows that a noun is an instrument that helps us to do something. For example, I draw with a pencil. Pencil is an instrument. Pencil, карандаш. I draw, я рисую. Я рисую карандашом. Я рисую карандашом. Карандаш, я рисую карандашом. And the prepositional case, this case is always used with preposition. It usually shows a place or a subject of a speech and the thoughts when we speak or talk about something. So this subject will be in the prepositional case. For example, we talk about a weather. Now, weather is an object of a speech, of a talk. Weather, погода, погода. Мы говорим о погоде. Погода, мы говорим о погоде. So you see, six cases, all different nouns. And so now let's take one noun in all. Six cases, use it in all six cases. As an example, let's take a word нога, which means foot or leg. We have one word both for foot and leg. All this is нога in Russian. So nominative case. For example, a foot stops aching. A foot stops aching. Нога перестала болеть. So, subject in sentence. The same initial form. Нога перестала болеть. Нога, нога перестала болеть. Genitive case. Something refers to something of. Like strength of a foot. For example, strength of a leg. Сила. Strength. Сила. Сила ноги. Нога. Сила ноги, genitive case, of a leg, ноги, сила ноги. Нога перестала болеть, сила ноги. Dative case shows that something is given or addressed to something, showing direction. I pressed a bandage to my leg. I pressed a bandage to my leg. Direction to my leg. Я прижал, pressed. Я прижал повязку к ноге. К ноге. Нога к ноге. Я прижал повязку к ноге. Dative case. Accusative case. When a noun is an object of an action, we use this case. I raised my foot for a kick. Я поднял ногу для удара. For a kick or for a hit. Я поднял ногу для удара. Ногу. Нога is an object. We raised it. Ногу. Нога. Я поднял ногу. Я поднял ногу для удара. Я поднял ногу для удара. Instrumental case. Noun is an instrument that helps us to do something. I pushed a box with my foot. A foot is an instrument. Я толкнул коробку ногой. Нога толкнул ногой. Толкнул, pushed. Я толкнул коробку ногой. Ногой. And prepositional case. It shows a place or an object of speech and the thoughts. Now, in this example, it will be a place. I felt a pain in my leg. I was feeling pain in my leg. Я почувствовал боль в ноге. Where? Где? Where? In my leg. Я почувствовал боль в ноге. В in. Я почувствовал боль в ноге. So, нога, я почувствовал боль в ноге. And now let's repeat. Нога in all six cases. Нога перестала болеть. Сила ноги. Он прижал повязку к ноге. Bandage. Он прижал повязку к ноге. Я поднял ногу для удара. Я толкнул коробку ногой. Я почувствовал боль в ноге. So you see, one word, six forms. And now let's have a little training. I say English sentence, you say Russian. Let's start. My leg stopped aching. Нога перестала болеть. Нога перестала болеть. Strength of a leg or of a feet or foot. Сила ноги. He pressed a bandage to a leg. Он прижал повязку к ноге. The most important for you to remember a form of нога, ноге, ноги. It's okay if you forget other words of a sentence. I raised my foot for a kick, for a hit. Я поднял ногу для удара. I pushed a box with my foot. Pushed with my foot. Я толкнул коробку ногой. Я толкнул коробку ногой. I felt a pain in my leg. Я почувствовал боль в ноге. Я почувствовал боль в ноге. Again, I repeat you again all sentence because only this is the only way for you to remember. Listening. Нога перестала болеть. Сила ноги. Он прижал повязку к ноге. Я поднял ногу для удара. Я толкнул коробку ногой. Я почувствовал боль в ноге. So this is all for today. This is only one case of six cases with one word, with one noun. I will make some more lessons, but I can't make you for all words, for all possible words, all possible examples. You just don't be afraid to make a mistake. Listen as much as you can. And also, you may subscribe to my Everyday WhatsApp lessons. This time we learn cases of nouns. Every day, one word in all cases, every day. This is all for today. Subscribe my YouTube channel if you haven't yet. Join our Facebook page Let's Learn Russian and Make Friends. Давайте учить русский и дружить. Пока!